Hey, what is going on, guys? We are here today doing something a little bit different. Somehow this passed me by. Normally the PTS patch notes don't pass me by. Because to be completely honest, I normally catch them on somebody's YouTube channel. You know, Incon seems to do them either on his YouTube channel or on his stream. So I normally catch them on either of them. But I literally just saw it, so I was like, okay, well, we definitely have to check this out. And I figured, what better way to do that than do it with you guys? So, yeah, first of all, it looks like Expelled from Hell is going to be the theme of it, which I think is kind of cool, but I don't use Hell, so. Firstly, we've got this skin. I mean, that's pretty cute. Like, I can see people wanting that. That's a little bit like the Neith. I don't know what you call it, like the little Japanese skin that she's got.
Let's rid them of their pathetic lives!
Whoa, that's a little dark, don't you think?
Okay, so that's jokes. What I didn't realize is that's obviously the second side where I completely forgot about that, and her voice pet changes as you switch between the two. And I'm sure it's probably the case with most skins, but as I said, I don't play her. A Sun Wukong skin, it looks nothing like Sun Wukong because he has no hair. So, I mean, this is cool. Like, if you don't like the look of Sun Wukong, then at least you've got a new choice now. So I kind of like that. That's pretty sweet. Yeah, I don't really get the idea of it. Like, it looks like he's half rock or something, which I didn't know that was a thing with him. Maybe it is. I haven't read his lore. Oh, you've got a Posh and her skin to go with the Cuckoo skin and the various other ones in that pack, the Fenrir skin as well. That's pretty awesome. I do like the Fenrir skin. I got it recently and I've used it a couple of times. It's really fucking cool. But that might actually be cooler. I mean, that looks fucking dope as hell. You got a new rat skin. I already fucking love this. That is unbelievably amazing. So this is some sort of like, well, it's clearly a pilot skin, but it looks like his nuts are going to turn into bombs. So yeah, that's fucking cool. Any sort of like, you know, animation or, you know, visual difference on stuff that isn't the character, I find really cool as well. So they recently released a Skadi skin. I think it's called Ski Patrol, where, Colda, the dog, is a, God, I don't know the name of the dog, but the dog has changed. Instead of being a wolf, it's a dog now. So stuff like that I find really, 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 really cool. So I'm feeling I'm probably going to end up getting that one. This is cool. I think this is going to be a tier 2, so that will be 250 gems. You know, it's a nice change. They recently released another one of these for Hui Yi, and it looked equally as nice. So that's cool. As you can tell by the pause in my audio, I don't know what the fuck that is, but I just realized we missed a couple of voice packs, so we're gonna have to go over these quick. So we've got some.
I will punish my enemy's foolish aggression.
Okay, so that sounds cool.
A little blood sport to pass the time, shall we?
Okay, that's fucking excellent. So we might actually end up getting that as well. That's
you're about to witness some aviation history, baby.
Okay, so that's the same voice pack, the same, everything's the same except for maybe the lines, like the recorded lines.
The only Canuck you'll see for kilometers.
Okay, that's fucking excellent. So this is a Canadian moose. So this might be the best thing I've ever seen in my life. This is fucking fantastic. I play Chiron now and then. I'm not too keen on his kit, but I might have to get back into him just so that when this patch comes live, I can... oh, fuck me. Okay, so that I can... buy that skin because that's fucking unbelievable. Right, I've just spotted this Susanoo Mastery skins. Holy tits, guys. These should look fucking amazing. I think I'm already Mastery 3, Mastery 4. I might try and get Mastery 5 before it comes out just for the black and gold. And if the diamond looks good enough, then pff, might be playing Susanoo for the next week. We've got a couple of achievements, you know, they're nothing too interesting. Stuff with our Posh, a little bit of Fafnir, that's understandable. More stuff with... Oh, yeah, that's Fenrir, sorry. Some stuff with Fenrir. Another cutesy one. They seem to be doing a couple of these. I don't understand why that's cutesy. Like the Thor one and a couple others have been a bit cartoony, but that looks fucking weird as hell. The escape menu has undergone a visual update. Okay. Well, I'm sure that's going to be interesting. Okay. So, by the looks of things, there's nothing too interesting here, except for they're starting a new coupon system that's in beta. I think the idea of that is so that instead of having to buy gems as a gift for somebody, you can literally get coupons and trade them around and, you know, whatever it is. Item changes. Okay. So, I was going to say they've nerfed it, but they haven't. I mean, Bloodforge is so unbelievably strong at the moment. And if you go into Assault and you're against any assassin or any fucking hunter, you'll know how strong Bloodforge is. This item isn't even that much, like 2,850, I think it is, for 75 power. And then a huge shield when you kill somebody. And basically what it does is it allows you to snowball. As soon as you kill somebody, you get that shield and you can go in for another kill because you've got this massive shield. They've done nothing to the shield. They've just reduced the movement speed a little bit, which is nothing. That's nothing. 10 to 20 is nothing. That means nothing. So Bloodforge is still as strong as it always has been. I love Demonic Grip, so this will be interesting. Okay, so that's cool. So I think by the looks of things, you're getting 8, 16, 32, 12, 24, 36. So you're getting an increased, I was going to say penetration, but it's not. I think it's you're dropping their protections. So in effect, it's penetration. But you're going from 32% to 36%, so you're getting an extra 4% drop in their protections, and it now takes you 3 hits to do it instead of 4 hits they used to get max protection drop. So that's really good. Demonic Grip's probably going to be picked up a little bit more now. I mean, it's a really small little thing, but it's probably needed. Four hits to get a full is not typical in the world of Smite. Normally, most things take 3. Like, for instance, Spirit Madness and I think Itchable. And there's probably fucking tons of others, but stacks now provide 12% reduction at Capture Attention. Okay, so the Executioner was literally identical to Demonic Grip. I wasn't aware of that. And what I just said then, you're going to be getting an extra 4% drop in. That's a drop in reductions. This, I think, is a actual penetration. Anyway, Throwing Dagger has been reduced. I think the idea of this, well, I was going to say the idea of this one is so that people don't pick up the tier 2 and move on with the rest of their build. But to be honest, most people, because of the 55 power, pick up the tier 3 before they move on these days. Back in the day, a couple PTSs ago, I think the typical thing to do, and it's certainly what I've done as a hunter, is to pick up Throwing Dagger and leave Golden Bow because it just wasn't worth it. It was like 10% crit and like an extra 15 power or something like that. They've dropped that, so essentially Throwing Dagger is not really that great anymore, and your wave clear might not be that amazing. And then eventually when you pick up Golden Bow, it's 5 less power. That didn't make much difference. Mark of Vanguard, something I do not use, but yeah, having an extra bit of physical protection is kind of cool. I guess this is, I've kind of been waiting for this, when most people do sort of start being like, okay, well, we're just, you know, we've got to get them more into picking up starter items because a lot of people just ignore them completely. Soul Reaver, this should be interesting. Passive damage reduced from 15% to 10%. Now, to me, that's always been on the border. I find the passive to be really close to annoyingly bad. Like, I think at one point it used to be something ridiculous, like 20-25%. And obviously that was overpowered. And I thought when they dropped it back to 15% that it was sort of okay. The main reason you pick up Soul Reaver is because it's one of the only items, or one of the items in the game that has 100 power on it when you're a mage. But yeah, that's really, really disappointing. It basically takes a lot of the spike out of it, like 10%. You feel 15%, you might not feel 10%, so that's shit. But then they reduce the cooldown to 40 seconds instead of 60, so I guess that sort of evens it out a little bit. So yeah, we'll just say that's the same as it always has been. Damage reduced. Oh, that's interesting. Magical scaling reduced. Okay, so I played out Kwong a little bit, and depending on the comp on the other team, I can be pretty effective with him, as most people can be. But Water Illusion is not one of the abilities. I mean, if I get the chance to poke with it, I will, but it's not one of the abilities I'm like, well, I'm going to get some damage off with this, then I'll do these two to get the rest. It's always if they manage to stroll into where I've went invisible, then that's just a bonus. So that to me means fuck all, and I'm sure it won't mean much to anybody else really. Fixed an issue where explosive bolts could miss enemies at max range. That sounds buggy as fuck. Good job. Reduced his. That's a bit disappointing. So that's a really annoying move for Osiris, because you always see him to be a melee character, and he's actually got quite a bit of range with that ability, and now he's going to have it more often. But cool for all the Osiris players out there. Healing reduced, thank fucking god. Scaling reduced, thank the lord. Because that's good, you should see, you know, that should make a little bit of difference. I mean, he still needs to be nerfed, like fuck, he's still ridiculous. Okay, so yeah, I mean, this has been coming for a little while. They reduced the scaling in the last patch from 90 a hit to 80 a hit, so that's 180 down to 160 scaling once you've hit both tiers of the ability. And dash speed reduced. Okay, well, you did pretty much teleport across the map. It was a really fast dash. So yeah, that might help. Catching him while he dashes away, and that was needed as well. I'd say, looking at those numbers there, and now the scaling's been dropped a little bit, he's pretty close to balanced. I'd say if they took maybe the scaling on the Storm Katana down to like 75 instead of 80, then he'd probably be pretty close. Updated sound effects on the teleport, increase the cooldown. Yeah, okay, sweet. So that's good. It means you can't TP around the place like crazy. Oh god. Okay, so Thanatos didn't need a buff, but he's got one. So if you get hit by that early game and he's got red pot on, you're gonna have a bad day. And enemies affected by frostbite now deal 10% less damage to all targets. No, that looks like it's just a straight add to the game. It doesn't look like it's replacing anything. It doesn't look like anything's being changed. It just looks like it's being added, which I think is really cool. That gives him so much more support. Because, you know, if he does his ult and he hits a couple targets, then if they try to turn around afterwards and get aggressive, obviously that's going to be great for your team. So, yeah, a couple things. Thanatos, ridiculous. Soul Reaver is going to be the same, so I don't really need to go over that. Demonic Grip, that's going to be really cool. Bloodforge, that's a joke. I mean, actually nerf it, because it's insane. What else? These should be interesting. That
the only Canuck you'll see for kilometers
is just fucking fantastic. I mean, I can't tell you how excited about that I am, but it's just unreal. And equally, I don't play Hell, but I might have to get into her, because these two are fucking cool. I really like that. So yeah, guys, I mean, this is just a quick little update if anybody missed it. It's going to be a little bit late, and I'll try and get it out today, because this already got released on the 15th, and it's the 18th. So yeah, I'll upload it, and if anybody missed it, then it's a quick run through of what's going on when this becomes live, which will be possibly next Tuesday. Which is the 21st. Is it going to be the 21st or the 28th? So yeah, peace guys. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.